Morning, students. So in the yesterday's class we discussed about the properties of friction materials and also what are the different types of materials that are used. Okay, and we also discussed the derivation of uniform wear theory. Okay, so today we are going to discuss the general design procedure for friction plate clutches. Okay, and also some numericals basing on design of clutches. So first have a look at, this is also available in the textbook, but first have a look at the design procedure. So generally the design consideration mainly depends upon how to obtain the best balance between the maximum torsional moment, that is torque, and the effective operating life. Okay, so in order to design a friction plate clutch, what all you should have, what data you should have? You should have torsional moment, that is torque to be transmitted, limiting dimensions of the clutch like inner diameter, outer diameter, okay, thickness, okay, and what is the pressure then to engage the clutch plates. So whether it is a single disc or multi-disc construction, so these four data you should have, must and should, in order to design a friction plate clutches. Okay, so first look, you have a look at the first step. Have a look at the first step. So your torque transmitted is given by MT is equal to 9550 into 1000 into N divided by N. Okay, so here N is your power and the small n is your RPM. Okay, and your power here is in kilowatts. So alternatively, you can also use P is equal to 2 pi NT by 60,000. That also you can use, and you can get the so power or torque, whatever you want, right? So the only difference is this equation directly gives you the torque in Newton mm. Newton mm. Okay, so if you use P is equal to 2 pi NT by 60,000 and substitute power in terms of kilowatt, you will get a torque in Newton meter. So further, you will need to be converted into Newton millimeter by multiplying 1000 or 10 to the power 3. So that is the difference. Okay, this is available in data handbook. Then diameter of the shaft is given by D is equal to, this is cube root of 16 MT divided by pi into 2S into eta. Okay, then mean diameter, as we have seen these things in the derivations. So for uniform pressure condition, you can see here, for uniform pressure condition, so DM is 2 by 3 D2 cube minus D1 cube divided by D2 square minus D1 square, the same thing is here. For uniform wear condition, D mean is D2 plus D1 divided by 2. Okay, see here, mean diameter D2 plus D1 divided by 2. Then axial force, for uniform pressure, it is pi P into D2 square minus D1 square divided by 4. Uniform pressure, you can see here, axial force is pi into P into D2 square minus D1 divided by 4. Whereas for uniform wear theory, it is 1 by 2 pi P into D1 into D2 minus D1. That's what it is given here. So using these equations, you can calculate the you can equate the torque with all these equations and find out the dimensions, okay, and also the axial force. So generally thickness is taken from 1 to 3 mm. Okay, there is no hard and fast formula to calculate the thickness of the disc, so you can take anywhere between 1 and 3. So generally what I will be taking is the average of 1 and 3, that is 2 mm I will be taking thickness of the disc, right? So this is a design procedure in general for friction plate of friction plate clutch. Now let's see a simple numerical. Okay, this is from your textbook JVK Das, example number 6.1. A car engine develops maximum power of 15 kilowatts, okay, 15 kilowatts at 1000 rpm. The clutch used is single plate type of both sides effective. So the clutch plate is effective on both sides. That means friction material is applied on the both sides of the friction plate, okay, not only single side. So how is it significant? When the friction material is present on the both side and the both sides of the friction plate is effective, you have to take the number of effectives of contact surfaces. I is equal to 2 here. Okay, I is equal to 2. If only one side is effective, then you take I is equal to 1. Okay, so its external diameter is 1.25 times the internal diameter. That is, D2 is equal to 1.25 into D1. D1 is the internal diameter, D2 is the external diameter. The coefficient of friction is given as 0.3. Maximum axial pressure is not to exceed 0.085 Newton per mm square. Okay, so he wants you to determine the dimensions of friction surface and the force necessary to engage the plates. That means he wants to determine the D1, D2 and H, and also the FA, that is axial force. So he wants you to assume uniform pressure condition. Uniform pressure condition. Remember one thing, whenever we are solving numericals in clutches, okay, unless he mentions that you use uniform pressure condition, by default you have to always take uniform wear condition, because the mechanism of clutch plate is always majorly governed by the wear condition. Okay, so unless he mentions that you use uniform pressure condition, you have to always take uniform wear condition. Only if he says assume uniform pressure condition, then you have to use formulas relevant to uniform pressure condition. Okay, so we have written all the data here. Power n is equal to 15 kilowatts, rpm smaller than is 1000 rpm, I the number of effective contact surfaces is 2 because it is effective on both sides as we discussed. External diameter D2 is given in terms of internal diameter D1, 1.25 times D1, and the coefficient of friction is given as 0.3, and the uniform pressure is 0.085 Newton per mm square. Okay, so let's take that formula. MT is equal to 9550 into 1000 into capital N by N, where capital N is the power in terms of kilowatt. Okay, so if you get that, you will get, write the unit here. So you will get the torque in Newton mm, 143250. Okay, so according to uniform pressure condition, your dm mean diameter is 2/3 into d2 cube minus d1 cube divided by d2 square minus d1 square, right? So here what I have done is, so we know that d2 external diameter is 1.25 times the d1, and we do not know the values of either d1 or d2. So wherever there is a d2, I have substituted 1.25 d1. Okay, so if you just calculate it, work it out mathematically, it comes out to be 1.13 times d1. What is that? Dm mean diameter dm is 1.13 times of d1. Okay, next is axial force for uniform pressure condition is pi p into d2 square minus d1 square by 4. So pi into p is given as 0.085 Newton per mm square. Be careful with the units, all the things have to be corresponding to Newton and mm. Okay, again where there is a d2, I have substituted 1.25 d1. So again you will get fa, that is axial force for uniform pressure condition, in terms of d1 square. Okay, so now that you know the torque transmitted is also is equal to, for uniform pressure condition, 1/2 into coefficient of friction into axial force into mean diameter into the number of active contact surfaces, which in this case it is 2. Okay, just refer to our design case procedure. Okay, this is the equation I am referring to. Okay, so we know the torque transmitted, we calculated 143250. Okay, 1/2, coefficient of friction is 0.3, FA is 0.037552 into d1 square. Okay, and dm is 1.13 into d1 multiplied by number of active contact surfaces, which is 2, right? If you just so you can see only d1 is a variable here. It's a quadratic equation in terms of d1 square and d1. If you just solve this equation, you will come out to be d1 is equal to 224 millimeters. So corresponding, you will calculate other dimensions. D2, you know, 1.25 times d1, so 1.25 into 224, 280. Dm is 1.13 into d1, that is 253. Fa is this value, so we'll get 1884.21 newton. So thickness, as I said, it varies in between 1 to 3 mm, so we can always assume it as 2 mm. Okay, so this is a simple problem basing on design of friction plate and clutches. So it will be asked for maybe 6 or 8 marks. Okay, steps are very simple, not much complications in this module. Now let's see another problem. So design a single plate clutch consisting of 2 pairs of contacting surfaces. The moment you see 2 pairs of contacting surfaces, it means I is equal to 2. Okay, for a torque capacity of 200 newton meter, torque is already given, 200 newton meter, that is nothing but 2 into 10 to the power 5 newton mm. So due to space limitations, the outside diameter is restricted to 250 mm, that means D2 he has given as 250 mm, right? Okay, so here what he has not given as compared to previous one, he has not given pressure and he has not given coefficient of friction. So these things are to be taken from data handbook, from table 19.7. okay, so you can actually assume whatever material you want, but for simplicity assume leather material for which dry friction coefficient is 0.3 to 0.5. it is given as 0.3 to 0.5 in the data handbook. So what I am doing is, you can take any value from 0.3 to 0.5. So for calculation purposes, I will take the average of 0.3 to 0.5, which is 0.4. Okay. Similarly, the pressure can vary from 0.086 to 0.2746 megapascal, and I have taken the average of these two things. So this data is available in the handbook. This pressure value and coefficient friction, these are available in the data handbook. Okay. So I have taken the average of this, you get as 0.1716 newton per mm square. These two things he had not given, I have taken from the data handbook. So procedure remains same again. Mt is given, okay, but notice that here he has not given whether to assume uniform pressure condition or uniform wear condition. So what you have to do, as I said, you have to assume uniform wear condition. All your calculations will be corresponding to uniform wear. Okay, uniform wear. So mean diameter as per uniform wear condition is dm is equal to d1 plus d2 by 2. So d2 is given as 250, d1 is not given, you have to calculate it. So just substitute it and you will get 250 plus d1 divided by 2. So axial force as per uniform wear condition is fa is equal to half pi p d1 into d2 minus d1. Substitute the values, you will get 0.269 d1 into 250 minus d1. Okay, last to calculate dimensions, equate this equation. So torque is 2 into 10 to the power 5, half coefficient of friction, average I have taken 0.4, multiplied by fa. Fa I have got as 0.269 d1 into 250 minus d1, that I have put here. Dm is 250 plus d1 divided by 2, that we have put here, multiplied by number of active contact surfaces, that is 2. Okay, substitute this value and you will get an equation in terms of d1 cube, okay, minus d1 and all. If you just solve it out mathematically, or you can directly input this equation into calculator. I have told you how to solve the equation in the calculator. Okay, so your d1 will come out to be 63.59, approximately 64 millimeters. Then you can calculate the corresponding d2 value, dm value and axial force value. Okay, and thickness, as I said, it is ranging between 1 to 3 mm, so I have taken thickness as 2 mm. So these are your final dimensions. Okay, So these two numericals are giving you an idea of how design friction plate clutch is designed, the single plate. Okay, so in the coming classes we will see further problems, right? Thank you.